A third fundamental that we want to talk about today is ball position. There's really a couple different thoughts that you can use for ball position, but in this case, I've got a wedge, I've got a 6-iron, and I've got a driver. If you set up here with a wedge with a narrow stance, you can see that that ball looks very similar or very close to the middle of my stance. If I took my 6-iron and I just widened my stance, you can see that I've not moved the ball position, but the ball appears to be more forward. Same thing is true if I bring a driver in there. I'm just going to widen my stance, not necessarily move the ball anywhere, but the ball appears to be moving more forward. At this point with the driver, you can see that it's more off my left heel, left instep right there, but I really haven't moved the ball. The second thought on this, if you guys want to play with this at home, if you just have your stance narrow and you have this ball in the middle of your stance, basically off your shirt buttons for a wedge, you're just only going to move the ball a little bit more forward there for a 6-iron or so, and obviously a little bit more forward for a driver. So the ball actually moving from a wedge to a driver is only going to be a couple balls, so there's not a lot of movement. We don't want it behind our shirt buttons at any point unless you're trying to do something special with the ball. But if you can imagine the ball basically from the shirt buttons kind of to my left pec or to your emblem here on your shirt, that's basically where the ball position is going to sit for all shots in golf.